Namaskara. Today I would like to have a discussion on estimation of lime and soda ash at the water treatment plant. Mainly, the lime and soda ash together will be used for softening, that is to remove the hardness. The hardness in the water is due to presence of calcium and magnesium salts, either in the form of carbonates or bicarbonates. There are many other technologies that have come recently, either it might be a reverse osmosis or resin based ion exchange process, wherein we can achieve 0% hardness in the water. That means 100% of hardness can be removed by reverse osmosis as well as ion exchange process. Lime soda process is the other type of technique wherein the lime takes care of the temporary hardness and the soda ash takes care of the permanent hardness. In households, we usually remove the temporary hardness by boiling. So, in this connection, I have taken one problem. Let us have a discussion on this problem. A raw water consists of the following characteristics. Calcium carbonate 250 mg per liter, magnesium bicarbonate 150 mg per liter, calcium sulfate 80 mg per liter, magnesium chloride 250 mg per liter, common salt NaCl 25 mg per liter, Fe2O3 iron oxide 40 mg per liter, and silicon dioxide SiO2 30 mg per liter, and magnesium sulfate 100 mg per liter. So, before going further, first we should understand which chemical imparts hardness. So, in this particular problem, so calcium carbonate imparts hardness, magnesium bicarbonate imparts hardness, calcium sulfate imparts hardness, magnesium chloride imparts hardness, and magnesium sulfate imparts hardness. That means NaCl, Fe2O3 and SiO2 will not impart the hardness. That means when we are going for solving the problems, it's very important that first we should understand due to what chemical the hardness is imparted in the water. In this connection, I have considered few reactions just to throw a light. Carbon dioxide imparts hardness because when we are considering acidity test, the acidity in the water is due to presence of carbon dioxide or the mineral acids. So both of these things impart temporary hardness to the water. So calcium bicarbonate also imparts the temporary hardness. Magnesium bicarbonates also imparts the temporary hardness. MgCO3, MgSO4, MgSO4 imparts permanent hardness, but again this can be removed both by lime as well as the soda ash. MgCl2 imparts permanent hardness, however this will be removed both by lime as well as the soda ash. CaCl2 imparts hardness, but to remove calcium chloride imparted hardness, we'll be going for making use of soda ash alone. Similarly, calcium sulfate imparts hardness. Here also, it imparts permanent hardness. To remove this calcium sulfate, we'll be going for soda ash. That means it's very important that first we should understand in a given problem which material imparts hardness. That means there are some materials that are being mentioned which will not impart any hardness in the water. So that means we should not consider these things for estimation of the lime and soda ash quantities in the water treatment. Let us now go further. So once the characteristics are being mentioned, so in this case I have considered few characteristics. Again, likewise, we can consider carbon dioxide also. So, again, carbon dioxide is removed by what? Lime. So, Likewise, we can consider many other chemicals, so we can solve the problem. But just to demonstrate, I have considered one problem. So that means a raw water consists of the following. Here, the characteristics of the raw water in terms of the hardness is being given. So just to confuse, NaCl, Fe2O3 and SiO2 characteristics are also being given. So we will not be considering in case of softening. Compute the requirement of slaked lime and soda ash for treating 1 lakh liters of water on daily basis. That means this water is having these characteristics. The quantity of the water that needs to be treated is how much? 1 lakh liters on daily basis. Consider the purity of slaked lime as 85% and soda ash as 90%. So that means quantity of water is given. The quantity of water to be treated is given. How much? 1 lakh liters. Purity of slaked lime. That means slaked lime means what? Slaked lime means we usually go for lime. When it is mixed with water, it forms CaOH. That means it will get converted to calcium hydroxide. That is nothing but slaked lime. The purity of this one is 85%. The purity of soda ash. Soda ash is Na2CO3 chemical form. So it is having purity of how much? 90%. Now let us try to understand first which hardness is removed by what material. So that means when I say calcium carbonate, it will be removed by lime. When it comes to MgHCO3 twice, it will be removed by lime. When it comes to calcium sulfate, it will be removed by soda ash alone. When it comes to magnesium chloride, MgCl2, it will be removed by lime as well as soda ash. When it comes to MgSO4, it will be removed by lime and soda ash. That means first we should know which material is being used by these chemicals so that there will be reduction in their particular quantity. For that, we need to understand these chemical reactions. That means this is just a glimpse and just go through. Now coming to the next part, it's very important, so we need to understand. So here, since the quantity of calcium carbonate CaCO3 that needs to be removed is how much? 250 mg per liter. MgHCO3 twice, the quantity that has to be removed is how much? 150 mg per liter. CaSO4, that is how much? 80 mg per liter has to be removed, and MgCl2 is 250 mg per liter that has to be removed, and MgSO4 is how much? 100 mg per liter that has to be removed. Now it's very important that first we are going to prepare a table. Type of the hardness which has to be removed along with the molecular weight of that particular chemical. So calcium is having molecular weight, atomic mass how much? 40, carbon 12, oxygen 60, similarly hydrogen 1. When we discuss about magnesium, 24. When we discuss about sulfur, it is 32. When we discuss about sodium, right, it is 23. Similarly, when we will be discussing with respect to MgCl2 or so when we will be discussing Cl, that means 35.45 or nearly 35.5. Once we prepare the table, so in the first column we are going to make use of material used to remove the hardness along with its molecular weight. That means lime is used by calcium carbonate so that the hardness imparted by this particular material will be reduced. That means calcium hardness is having how much concentration? 250 mg per liter. What is the molecular weight of calcium carbonate? 100. What is the molecular weight of lime, that is hydrated lime? It is calcium 40, 16 into 2, that is 32, that is 72, plus 2 multiplied by 1, that is atomic mass of hydrogen, that means we will be getting 74. That means to remove 100 mg per liter of calcium carbonate, it consumes 74 amount of lime. That means for removing 250 mg per liter, how much quantity of lime is required? So that means 74 by 100 multiplied by 250 mg per liter. So that means we are going to get 185 mg per liter. That is the quantity of which material? Lime. Going to the next part, MgHCO3 twice. To remove this MgHCO3 twice, we'll be making use of lime. That means lime is used to remove the hardness imparted by MgHCO3 twice. So again, the molecular weight of lime is 74. The molecular weight of MgHCO3 twice is how much? 146. That means 146 mg per liter of MgHCO3 twice requires 74 mg per liter of lime. That means 150 mg per liter of MgHCO3 requires how much? So for that we will be going for 74 divided by 146. Here it is very important that 1 unit of MgHCO3 twice requires 2 units of lime. That's why we will be multiplying by 2. That means 2 multiplied by 74 divided by 146. The concentration of MgHCO3 twice is how much? 150. So we will be getting 152.05 mg per liter. Going to the third substance, that is CaSO4. That is a characteristic of the water in terms of hardness. The calcium sulfate is having concentration of 80 mg per liter. As already we have discussed, the atomic mass of calcium is 40, sulfur is 32 and oxygen is 16. We are going to get molecular weight of CaSO4 as 136. To remove 136 mg per liter of calcium sulfate, we'll be making use of soda ash. The chemical formula for soda ash is Na2CO3. So sodium is having atomic mass of 23, carbon 12 and oxygen 16. So that means the molecular weight of this soda ash is how much? 106. That means 136 mg per liter of calcium sulfate requires 106 mg per liter of soda ash. Therefore, 80 mg per liter of calcium sulfate requires how much quantity of soda ash? That means 106 divided by 136 multiplied by 80, we are going to get 62.35 mg per liter of soda ash, which is required to remove hardness of 80 mg per liter, which is being imparted by CaSO4. Going to MgCl2. That means the next one. So here the concentration of MgCl2 in the water is 250 mg per liter. That means the molecular weight of MgCl2 is 95 and the concentration is 250 mg per liter. This MgCl2 will be removed both by lime as well as soda ash. Lime is having molecular weight how much? 74, because it is having chemical formula CaOH twice, that's why it is 74. And coming to soda ash, its molecular weight is 106. Therefore, to remove 250 mg per liter of MgCl2 by making use of lime, the quantity of lime required is 74 divided by molecular, 74 is the molecular weight of lime divided by molecular weight of MgCl2 is 95 multiplied by 250 mg per liter is the concentration. Therefore, the quantity of lime required to remove MgCl2 is how much? 194.73 mg per liter. Similarly, to remove the hardness imparted by MgCl2 of 250 mg per liter, again soda ash will be acting. That means the molecular weight of soda ash Na2CO3 is how much? 106 divided by molecular weight of MgCl2 is how much? 95. The multiplied by concentration of the MgCl2 in the water is 250. That means that quantity of soda ash required to remove 250 mg per liter of MgCl2 hardness will be 278.95 mg per liter. Similarly, there is one more hardness that is being imparted by MgSO4. The quantity of MgSO4 to be removed is, the concentration of the MgSO4 to be removed is how much? 100 mg per liter. The molecular weight of MgSO4 will be how much? 120, because magnesium is having atomic mass of 24, sulfur 32 and oxygen 16. That means 64 plus 32 plus 24, we are going to get 120 as a molecular weight of magnesium sulfate. To remove magnesium sulfate hardness, lime and soda ash together will be acting. That means the quantity of lime required to remove the MgSO4 hardness will be how much? 74 divided by molecular weight of MgSO4, that is 120, multiplied by concentration of MgSO4 100. So that means the quantity of lime required to remove magnesium sulfate is 61.66 mg per liter. MgSO4 can also be removed by making use of soda ash. That means soda ash will also remove the MgSO4 imparted hardness. That means soda ash is having molecular weight of 106. 106 multiplied by 100 mg per liter of MgSO4 divided by molecular weight of MgSO4 is 120. The quantity of soda ash required to remove MgSO4 imparted hardness will be 88.33 mg per liter. Now, that means what we have done? We have now found out the quantity of lime required for removing individual hardness. Either it might be calcium carbonate, MgSO3 twice, or it might be MgCl2, or it might be MgSO4. That means we are going to add the total quantity of lime required. That means the total quantity of lime required is 593.44 mg per liter. Its purity is 85%. That's why we will be dividing it by 0.85 multiplied by 10 to the power minus 6, because it is in terms of mg. So I will be converting this one to kg. This multiplied by the total quantity of water to be treated is how much? 1 lakh liters. We have taken multiplication factor 365. The reason is that it has to be used for one full year, divided by 1000 to convert kgs to tons. That means we are going to get the total quantity of lime annually. It will be around about 25.5 tons. Similarly, the quantity of soda ash used. So if we go back to the solution, soda ash is used to remove calcium sulfate hardness. Soda ash is used to remove magnesium chloride hardness. Soda ash is used to remove magnesium sulfate hardness. That means calcium hardness, magnesium sulfate hardness and MgCl2 is being removed by soda ash. That means we are going to add 62.35 mg per liter plus 278.95 mg per liter plus 88.33 mg per liter. That means we are going to get 429.33 mg per liter of soda ash that is required. This is per liter requirement. What is the purity? 90%. So divided by 0.9 multiplied by 10 to the power minus 6 just to convert this mg to kg in, multiplied by 10 to the power 5. This is 1 lakh liter of water multiplied by 365. That is, this soda ash is required annually in a year 365 days. To convert this whole answer in terms of tons, I will be dividing it by 1000. So the total quantity of soda ash required is 17.41 tons. That means, as per the question, compute the requirements of slaked lime and soda ash for treating 1 lakh liters of water on daily basis. Considering 85% purity of lime and 90% purity of soda ash. That means the total quantity of lime required annually is how much? 25.48 tons. Similarly, soda ash required annually is how much? 17.41 tons. With this, I'll just close the discussion. Thank you.